Good morning students. Now today we are going to discuss about unit number 3, laws of motion. In unit number 3 we will discuss about module number 5. In module number 5, first of all we will discuss about conservation of linear moment. Conservation of linear moment. Conservation of linear moment. What is conservation of linear moment? If let us consider system of several interacting particles, first particle having mass m1 moving with velocity v1, second particle having mass m2 moving with velocity v2, third particle having mass m3 moving with velocity v2, and last particle means mn particle moving with velocity vn. According to law of conservation of linear momentum, if no external force acting on the system of several interacting particles, means total linear momentum of system will remain constant. If no external force acting on the system of several interacting particles, then total linear momentum will remain constant. If F external force, if F external force acting on the system of several interacting particles is zero, it means linear momentum of the system that is equal to constant. Linear momentum of the system is constant. Derivation of law of conservation. Derivation of law of conservation of linear momentum from Newton's second. Derivation of law of conservation of linear momentum from Newton's second law. Now, total linear momentum of the system. First particle, linear momentum m1 v1, second particle m2 v2, third particle m3 v3, and last particle linear momentum mn vn. Total momentum aaya aapke paas p, total linear momentum. M1 V1 that is equal to P1, linear momentum of first particle, that is equal to mass multiplied by velocity, plus linear momentum of second particle, that is mass multiplied by velocity, plus linear momentum of third particle, that is mass multiplied by velocity, plus linear momentum of nth particle, mass multiplied by velocity, that is equal to 0, which is equal to total linear momentum. According to Newton's second law, F is equal to dP divided by dt. Rate of change of momentum is directly proportional to force applied on the body. If external force that is equal to zero, then dP divided by dt that is equal to zero. dP upon dt that is equal to zero, it means linear momentum P is constant. So P is कॉन्स्टेंट, p इज कॉन्स्टेंट. फ्रॉम दिस इक्वेशन वी कैन से दैट इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ एक्सटर्नल फोर्स द लीनियर मोमेंटम ऑफ द सिस्टम विल रिमेन कॉन्स्टेंट, p रिमेन कॉन्स्टेंट. देयरफॉर p इज इक्वल टू कॉन्स्टेंट. Now, in next, we will discuss about derivations of law of conservation of linear momentum from Newton's third law. Law of conservation of linear momentum from Newton's third law.
Final momentum m1 mass of
फर्स्ट बॉडी मल्टीप्लाइड बाय वेलोसिटी माइनस एम वन यू वन, एम वन यू वन. हियर वी कैन सी दैट दिस कैन बी रिटन एज एम वन, एम वन वी वन माइनस एम वन यू वन. दिस इज इक्वेशन फर्स्ट. नाउ इंपल्स ऑफ फोर्स एफ बी ए, इंपल्स ऑफ फोर्स एफ बी ए दैट इज इक्वल टू फोर्स एक्सर्टेड ऑन बॉडी बी ड्यू टू बॉडी ए, एफ बी ए मल्टीप्लाइड बाई स्मॉल इंटरवल ऑफ टाइम डेल्टा टी दैट इज इक्वल टू चेंज इन मोमेंटम ऑफ बॉडी बी. चेंज इन मोमेंटम ऑफ बॉडी मीन्स मोमेंटम ऑफ बॉडी बी आफ्टर कोलिजन माइनस मोमेंटम ऑफ बॉडी ए बी बिफोर कोलिजन. दिस कैन बी रिटन एज एम टू वी टू माइनस एम टू यू टू. दिस इक्वेशन सेट. नाउ अकॉर्डिंग टू न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ, थर्ड लॉ एफ ए बी, एफ ए बी दैट इज इक्वल टू माइनस एफ बी ए. दिस इज इक्वेशन थर्ड. इक्वेशन थर्ड मल्टीप्लाइंग बाई डेल्टा टी बोथ साइड, इक्वेशन थर्ड मल्टीप्लाइंग बाई डेल्टा टी बोथ साइड एफ ए बी multiplied by delta t that is equal to minus f v a multiplied by delta t. This putting the value of f a b into delta t from equation first, sorry second, and f b a multiplied by delta t from equation third, putting these two values now we get F A B into delta T that is equal to M1 V1 minus M1 U1 that is equal to minus M2 V2 minus M2 U2. Therefore M1 V1 plus m2 v2 that is equal to minus minus plus minus minus plus m2 u2 plus m1 v1. This shows that momentum, total momentum after collision which is equal to total momentum before collision, total momentum before collision that is equal to total momentum after collision which shows linear momentum of the system will conserve. Now next one is we will discuss about applications of conservation of linear momentum. That is very very important, applications of conservation of linear momentum. Applications. Applications of conservation of linear momentum. Application of conservations of linear momentum. First one is recoiling of gun. Recoiling of gun. Recoiling of gun. Before we will take training to becomes a expert in firing system. Now recoiling of gun means this is a gun. Having mass capital L and the bullets the triggers mass of the gun capital M mass of the bullet small M during firing we put the gun on the shoulder because shoulder and gun becomes a single system that becomes having very large mass. Before firing we will check momentum, after firing we will check momentum. If linear momentum before firing that is equal to linear momentum after firing is same, it means law of conservation of linear momentum will obey. So before firing M with the mass of gun capital M with the mass of the gun small m with the mass of the bullet before firing velocity of the bullet that is u is equal to 0 velocity of the gun that is equal to velocity of the gun ki velocity aapke paas hai v that is equal to 0 so before firing capital M into 0 plus m into 0 that is equal to we will check momentum after firing mass of the gun capital M velocity of the gun v plus mass of the bullet small m velocity of the bullet u in left hand side this is 0 that is equal to capital M V plus M U V that is equal to V that is equal to minus M U divided by my capital M. This will indicate negative sign indicates gun move in backward direction. Backward. This velocity is called recoiling of gun. So during firing we will put our gun on the shoulder because shoulder and gun becomes a one system. Next one is explosion of bomb, also based upon law of conservation of linear momentums, rockets and jet planes also work on the principle of law of conservation of linear momentum. There are many applications in the physics on which law of conservation of linear momentum will be applicable. Rockets and jet planes also based upon law of conservation of linear momentum. Please stay tuned for module number 6. In module number 6 we will discuss about the next topic, friction. Thank you. Have a nice day. Thank you.